for the first time this year, the Tennessee Aquarium Conservation Institute was really pleased to partner with the Muir Fest. We took up nearly 1,000 Lake Sturgeon juveniles, and with the help of the public, released those into the Clinch River by the Watts Bar. This was a really great opportunity for the public to have a hands-on role in the conservation of this really cool fish. All sturgeon that are released into Watts Bar are tagged with a piece of coated wire. That little piece of metal that is inserted into their snout can be detected using a special device. When we recapture them, we can get a good idea of how and where and how quickly these fish are moving throughout the river system. This is the first year that the Tennessee Aquarium has released fish into Watts Bar, and that is based on part from a study that was published by the University of Tennessee grad student Todd Amaker that showed there's a much better prey availability in Watts Bar versus Fort Loudoun. So we decided to focus the bulk of our release into Watts Bar to give those young fish a better leg up at the start of their new life in the wild. And you know, this is an example of how scientific research can really impact and guide real world management decisions, as well as highlighting the significance of the work that graduate students do. We were really excited to see how many people were interested in coming and showing up for the Lake Sturgeon release. And you know, we could just tell that this was something they were really excited about. The kids were, you know, just stoked to help out with this. And I think that it's something that they'll remember for the rest of their lives.